Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
I've been wanting to sing for a while, and I thought this would be perfect. Thank you. I'm glad. But when you don't sing for a while, your voice goes down. So, I'm going to be working on that. But the point of today's sermon is the call, and will the answer. So these are the things that we will be talking about on the third Sunday after Epiphany. It is a beautiful day. The sun is shining, and it is a brisk, -3? George doesn't even care anymore.
It's either vacation.
Really? Do you have one scheduled?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Is it somewhere warm?
Yes. Yeah.
Pam, are you going too?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Friends, would you stand as we give thanks for our Thanksgiving and our Thanksgiving for baptism? Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light, and our salvation.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family. Through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your son was baptized by John and anointed by the Holy Spirit. By water and your word you claim us as your children, making us heirs of your promise and servants of all. We praise you for the gift of water that sustains life, and above all, we praise you for the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. Shower us with your Spirit. Shower us with your Spirit and renew our lives with your forgiveness, grace, and love. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us sing hymn number 588.
Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you." So Jonah set out and went to Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk. And he said, and he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh shall be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and everyone, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God changed his mind about the calamity that he had said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 62 will be read responsibly. For God alone I wait in silence. Truly my hope is in God.
God alone is my rock and my salvation, my stronghold, so that I shall never be shaken.
In God is my deliverance and my honor. God is my strong rock and my refuge.
Put your trust in God always, O people. Pour out your hearts before the one who is our refuge.
Those of high degree are but a fleeting breath. Those of low estate cannot be trusted. Placed on the scales together, they weigh even less than a breath.
Put no trust in extortion, in robbery, take no empty pride. For wealth increase, set not your heart upon it.
God has spoken once, twice have I heard him, that power belongs to God.
Steadfast love belongs to you, O Lord, for you repay all according to their deeds.
The second reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 7. Brothers and sisters, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing, and those who buy as though they had no possessions, and those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it. For the present form of this world is passing away. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Because we hear and see the soldiers come upon him and drag him away.
not because we see the crowds part and make way for the fugitive. By the way, when did he become a fugitive? Mark does not tell us, no, none of that. Now, after John was arrested, stay tuned. Eventually, we will pick John back up. But it's going to be a while. Friends, there are entire lifetimes lived in the gaps that Mark, the gospel writer, leaves in the telling of Jesus' journey. It's like he's playing the basic chords and a scant melody of a song you know vaguely, so that we have to listen closely to hear our parts. But Mark shares with us the important highlights, you know? The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news. What is the good news? Have you ever asked yourself that? It comes up a lot. The good news, Janine. You know. George? Not so much. Maybe. I often wonder and find myself, what in particular is Jesus talking about here? Mark presumes that we know it, or that it is simple to work out. And for Simon and Andrew, it was. They knew. Jesus said, come follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. We changed it so we're more inclusive. We say people. But he said fishers of men. And immediately they came. They dropped everything. And I wonder, what chords did Jesus play? What is the song in their head? Well, I talked to Julie this week, and we discussed it, and she said, that's Jeremiah 16. And I'm like, what do you mean, that's Jeremiah 16? She's like, oh yeah, I preached this, you know, last cycle, and I looked it up. I'm like, great, thank you. Jeremiah 16, you say. Now watch for what is coming next. I'm going to assemble a bunch of fishermen, God decrees. This comes from the Message version of the text. They'll go fishing for my people and pull them in for judgment. Then I will send out a party of hunters, and they'll hunt them out in all the mountains, hills, and caves. I am watching their every move. I haven't lost track of a single one of them, neither them nor their sins. Well, that puts a whole new spin on come be fishers of men, Judy. Have you heard that connection before? But you've heard become fishers of men, right? The chords that we play today aren't necessarily the chords that have been strummed throughout all of Christian history. So we have to rely on other chords and other land points, landmarks, so we can make sense of these texts. Jesus says, come follow me and I will make you fishers of men. Bring in the nets and return the beloved to me. Whatever I want to say to you, Jesus was offering these men employment, divine work. Come work for God. I do wonder what else they knew, what else they saw that would make Mark richer for us, easier to understand. What else did they hear? What else did they know? What was it about Jesus and his words that had them so easily set aside their nets and, in fact, their entire lives to walk with him? And for James and for John, the sons of Zebedee, sons of a man who owned his own boat and who was able to pay hired men on the side, these were settled men who would stand to inherit a life, maybe what's more important, a living. They had a job. But immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee and followed him. We are just graced with a few chords and a few notes, and we have to fill in our own melody to add the harmony and to lay the counter and compelling rhythm. And I'm really grateful for Dave and for Lois, because sometimes the how to say that. And you might say, well, good, you went to seminary for that. Thank God you got something out of it. I did go to seminary, and I got 2 degrees. But that's not where I know this story from. So you might say, I've preached it before. Well, Diane, I might have. But it was 25 years ago that I preached year B. It's been a long time. That isn't why I know it. I know it because I sang it. I learned that song in 1990. As a freshman in college, I bought Stephen Curtis Chapman's album and I wore it into the ground. That song is burned into me. So much so that when I read this text, I hear the rhythm and my throat moves the words. Does that ever happen to you? Lois plays a song and you know all the words. And you might not even remember where you first heard it. But chances are you were sitting in a place like this with a book like the red one, and your parents were sitting next to you, or your family was sitting next to you, or someone who could really sing, George, was sitting behind you. Maybe even now. The songs that are burnt into us is often our best theology. They are these songs. It isn't enough to hear them. The ones we sing and learn and know, and God help us, can't unlearn, change us. They fill in the gaps and transport us to other times. For me, it's a lonely freshman dorm room clinging to what I know is true. This music matters. And sometimes, there are entire lives lived in the gaps of what's in front of other people. Mark knew his business. This is the shortest of all 4 Gospels. He just hits the highlights, but he did it right. He knew that setting up the basic points would be so powerful that you would fill in the gaps. I see these men along the lake shore going about their business, pulling in their nets, sewing up holes, setting everything right, as a man approaches them and calls them by name. He sees them individually, and he speaks to their very self, the very core of who they are, by calling them by their very name. He doesn't know them. They are compelled by his call into their lives to follow him. Now, this is about as close as this Bethel Lutheran is ever going to get to an altar call. Brace yourselves. Hurt. Hold on. Have you ever felt that power come over you? That moment where you're like, Diane, go do that. Julie, I mean you. Barbara, I mean you. Have you heard that ever in your life? That moment of certainty, that moment of, I cannot avoid him, her, them, they know me. Sometimes it's out of the blue, there's a voice quietly saying, we need someone to step in here. And they mean you, Mickey. Have you ever felt that nudge in your car or on the corner of a street to just for now, step up and reach out your hand to somebody? Because you wouldn't normally do that, Denise. That's crazy. When someone knows your name, even in the quiet vault of your own soul, it's powerful. It removes all doubt, start, this road would not lead to faith. All they really knew for sure was Jesus had called to them. He said, come follow me. And they came with reckless abandon. Because that's what you got to do when you leave your entire life behind you, to do something crazy. Recklessly, Webster defines that as without thought or care of the consequences. Harold, have you done anything reckless lately? Oh, Harold. That's too bad. Gail, anything reckless?
No.
Denise is like, don't even start. I have not. What kind of faith do we need to be reckless, friends? What kind of faith is required of us? What does it mean for you? I really want you to ask that question. What would happen in this place if we started to hear our name being called? If we dropped the minutiae of our life and just stood up and followed Jesus? Now really, this is the altar call. What would it be like? What would happen if the good news left our nets on the seashore and pulled us up? Who would we reach out to? Elizabeth? Who could we feed? Who could we clothe? Who could know that they are beloved not just by God, but by God's people too, through us? For the sake of God's calling to the world, you are being asked. And in just a second, we're going to stand up. And you will be singing this question. You will sing it into being. And I dare you to think about what you sing. Because what we sing embeds itself in us, stirs us up, and sometimes screws us up. Because you just can't get it out of your head. I dare you to answer God's calling in your life. Harold, I double dog dare you. And I dare you to share it with your neighbors. And then I triple dog dare you. I don't even know what that is. I feel like I'm six. To listen and be changed by your neighbor's voice. Their calling and yours entwined to create church on earth. Did not, Harold. Even I know that that's a mistake. Harold wants to know who stuck their tongue on the post. That is not a good dare. Walk away from that one. But take mine on, Harold. Take on my dare. How is God calling you? Not for fame, not for glory, not for even being satisfied, but because you can make a difference in your neighbor's life. You can be changed by answering the call. And if you don't feel like I have said your name enough, just raise your hand. Richard, I double dog dare you. I say to this amen, but it is not finished. Please stand up and sing hymn number 798 as the sermon keeps on going. Amen.
Oh,
by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
As we celebrate Christ embodied in human form, we pray for God's blessing on the church, the world, and all of creation. God, our rock and deliverance, do not let your church be shaken. We trust you never abandon your promises to the most vulnerable among us. Give your church wisdom and empathy in its varied ministries. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
God, our hope and refuge, you place the fish in the sea. Guide our care of oceans and all creatures that live in them. Hold us accountable for actions that endanger water sources and the people who depend on them. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
God who proclaims judgment and offers mercy, be a model to the leaders of the nation and the world. As they lead, may they follow in your way of justice and truth. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
God who cares for the suffering, care for survivors of assault and of sexual abuse, and sustain all who minister to them. As the martyr Agnes ministered to victims of sexual abuse, keep safe any who live under threat of violence, those living in poverty, and any among us who are ill or in pain. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
God of resurrection and new life, as the first disciples shared the good news, empower us and this faith community to be open to your call. When we are uncertain of your call, assure us. When we have strayed from your ways, redirect us. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
God who holds the saints against your tender bosom, we trust you welcome them into your care. Comfort those who grieve, even as we place our hope in your salvation. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
This morning we offer prayers for Carolyn Doby, who now has COVID and has difficulty breathing. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Prayers also for my friend Bree. He has a court appearance over a constitutional issue on Wednesday. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
From whom else do we pray this morning?
For all those unable to be with us today, may they be safe, warm, and happy. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
For all those who are outside and who wish they were inside, God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Knowing the Holy Spirit intercedes for us, we offer these prayers and the silent prayers of our hearts in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May the peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Would you share that peace with each other?
Thank you.
blessed us with these gifts, ourselves and our time. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is indeed right, our duty and our delight, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By leading of the star, he was shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaimed him your beloved Son, and in the miracle of the water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Thank you.
and God knows you by name. Please, come.
Thank you.
Would you please stand? Let us pray.
O God, our life, our strength, and our food, we give you thanks for sustaining us with the body and blood of your Son. By your Holy Spirit, enliven us to be his body in the world, that more and more we will give you praise and serve your earth and its many people. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Please be seated. There are some announcements to be made today. I have it on good authority that almost all of the annual reports are in. Two are out.
We're on the website.
And they are published. If you do not have yours in, fix that. Mine's in, right? Thanks. Dang. Where were you, man? I needed your remembering for me. Pastor, have you put in your
Yes.
Thank you for asking, Dave. It wasn't on time, but it is in. Wonderful. This week, I will be away in Michigan for a sermon planning thing that I've been trying to do since I got here in March. It's just 2 days. But I won't be here for Monday morning coffee. So if you would pass that along to the pantry. If any of you are desiring to step in and cover for me tomorrow, I would be happy to tell you what I do. It's magic, really, the making of coffee. So please let me know if you feel called. If you need me to say your name, I'll just keep going until I find the person. What do you think, Jane? You're working, right?
Yes.
Right. Okay. Are there meetings this week?
Stewardship on Wednesday. Zoom.
Stewardship meeting on Zoom on Wednesday. Very good. Very good. That's just the best commute ever. Are there other announcements, other meetings? Rich?
Your annual giving statements are posted on the table. Please pick them up on your way up.
Very good. Otherwise, they will be mailed to you.
Correct.
So then you'll just have to wait for the U.S. Postal Service.
And send me a check to stamp an envelope.
Well, there it is. Paper goods drive for refugees here in town. In town, I mean the whole metro Chicago area. If you don't have that list, I think it's in your bulletin. That's so nice. I don't actually get that copy of the bulletin, so I never quite know what you have. So please, if you feel moved to create that packet or would like to collaborate with someone else to make a bag full of a shirt and some trousers and some socks and some gloves and some warm wishes for people in need, please feel called to do that and to bring those goods to the to the fellowship hall next to the red cart. We'll make sure it gets to where it's going.
Paper drive is for the food pantry.
Also, paper drive. Do not put those things together. Thank you. Annual meeting is February 25th. Be so moved. Please come on February 25th. We're going to have a potluck. There will be a sign up so that you can tell us what your favorite dish is that you are going to share with us. That's right, Denise. I won't be making your favorite dish. Well, I mean, I probably won't make it right, and if you waited for me to bring your favorite sauerkraut dish, you would wait a long time.
Don't worry, I only have one.
Well, good. Are there other announcements?
The sign-up's out there.
The sign-up's out there! Thank you, whichever fairy winged it and provided that sign-up. Are there other announcements? There are no other announcements. Would you please stand and receive the blessing? The Lord bless you and keep you. Lord, may his face to shine upon you. The Lord look upon you with grace and mercy and with favor. And may God give you peace. Amen.